Coming up next, we're going to talk about conscious observer connection. Okay. What I have done here is a kind of a study in how one defines whether the which way data is recorded. Can it just be recorded in the mind of a man? In other words, a man sees which slit it goes through. Does it have to be recorded on some kind of electrical recorder or written down on paper, some kind of hard copy? What are the requirements for this data being recorded? It's not clear whether it's just a person sees it or whether or not it has to be something that is objectively available to everyone. Now, it could be subjectively available. The man who sees it could say, oh, I see it. But though he makes that announcement, that doesn't make it objective. It's subjective. Okay, so here's going to be a whole series. You see, it goes 3A1 all the way out to 3C. And all of these are variations on different schemes for defining what makes which way data and what makes which way data go away. Okay, so we have people now, humans in the loop, and this has not been done before. It's really surprising that it hasn't. We know the observer effect is a very important effect here, but for some reason, this observer effect has never really been tested to find out exactly how critical is this observer and what does he have to observe in order to make his observation change the results of the experiment. So I'm not going to go through all of these. That would take a lot of trouble. You can see some of the conditions. The men, I have men in oscilloscopes. Okay, they replace R1 and R2. So R1 and R2, you see, are turned off. Instead, we have a line right out of detector 1 and detector 2 out to these oscilloscopes, which will put a little pulse on a screen. Okay, the men are always accurate, alert, knowledgeable, and truthful. To begin with, they're going to silently count pulses on their oscilloscope. And we can also do it with them not being silent, with them shouting it out and somebody else keeping a record of what they both say. Or they might record it with pencil and paper, or they might record it on an audio recorder. They may speak into it, or there may be some. They may take a picture of that pulse, and the picture also records the time. So there's lots of ways that we can change this and make it more or less accurate, more or less objective. Okay, the screen data, which is R3, is looked at after the experiment, and we're going to then do some of these versions will be during the experiment rather than after it. We can look at it as it hits the screen. And we can have it so that neither man can see the screen, so he can't really see where the particles hit, or we could have the men actually being able to see where those particles hit. So with all of those variations, we have a set of conditions for what are the minimum requirements for defining which way data. What constitutes an unacceptable logical conflict in PMR? Is subjective human memory sufficient as a data recorder? What constitutes an observation of which way data? Objectively recorded versus objectively witnessed. All right, I'm going to go on to the next. And you see there's lots of discussion and further notes here. Much to read if you want to get into the details. Three slides here just on the details of that one. So you can read that at leisure.